Good morning, children. Sai Ram. So let's continue with the remaining portion of chapter number 5 in political science, judiciary. When we talk about role of judiciary, two main features: dispute resolution and judicial review. Now, children, if we talk about dispute resolution, I repeat about dispute resolution. So what is dispute resolution? It means, dispute means dispute means a kind of argument between two people, or you can say two citizens of India. When we talk about that particular definition, we can say the judicial system provides a mechanism for resolving disputes between citizens and the government, between two state governments, and between the center and the state governments. Children, what is a dispute, and how does a dispute raises amongst anyone? See, children, dispute can be regarding to it can actually rise between two people or two governments due to lack of interest, interest served by the higher authorities. Now, when we talk about judicial review, you know that as the final interpreter of the constitution, that is the judiciary, has the power to strike down particular laws passed by the parliament. So, children, apart from the topic of judicial review, we directly switch to the justice system. Now, when we talk about the justice system, what is the justice system and what are the different branches of the legal system? See, children, when we talk about the branches of legal system in our society, we have two types of laws: one criminal law and the other civil law, that we discussed in the previous class as well. When we talk about the criminal law, first just paying focus on criminal law. When we talk about criminal law, what is it actually? It deals with the conduct or acts that the law defines as offenses. For example, theft, harassing a woman to bring more dowry, murder, etc. It usually begins with the lodging of an FIR, that is first information report, with the police, who investigate the crime, after which a case is filed in the court. And if found guilty, the accused can be sent to the jail and fined as well. This is called as the criminal law, which primarily discusses theft, harassment, dowry, or murder. Now, next, when we talk about the other law, that is the civil law. And now, what is civil law? First, civil law deals with any harm or injury to rights of individuals. For example, disputes relating to sale of land, purchase of land, purchase of goods, rent matters, divorce cases. These all come under civil law. A petition has to be filed before the court can take any relevant action. In a rent matter, either the landlord or tenant can file a case. Now, what is about this rent matter? What case has to be filed in a case of landlord or a tenant? First of all, who is a landlord and who is a tenant. A landlord is a person who, it can be he or she who owns a property, a house, a building, etc. And a tenant is the person who is living in that building, so house, etc. and paying a rent. Now, the code gives a specific relief asked for. For instance, if we are talking about a landlord and a tenant, the court can order the flat to be vacated and the pending rent to be paid. Now, children, we are going to talk about the topic that, does everyone have access to the courts or how? In principle, all citizens of India, all are equal and all can try the court. That is, all can file their case and all can file their plea, their problems in front of a high court or a lower court in the starting, so that they can get justice. But at times, what happens? Do you think that they are able to approach the courts? Even there are people who are not able to approach the lower courts. In such a case, children, how the people will get justice and keep their problems in front of the court? Because it is not easy as it is thought to keep the problem in front of the court. Now, what has happened? While the courts are available for all, in reality, access to courts has always been difficult for a vast majority of the poor in India. Legal procedures involve a lot of money and paperwork, as well as take up a lot of time. For a poor person who cannot read and write, whose family depends on a daily wage, the idea of going to court to get justice often seems remote, or you can say often seems abducted. Abducted means that none of the family members encourage. Whose family members? The person who is very poor, the person who does not even have money to eat food for two times. He does not have money that is sufficient to keep up a family. So do you think that such kind of a person will go ahead with the decision of keeping his problem in front of the court? No, not at all. So in such situation, the justice which is actually required, which is actually demanded by the poor person, is not granted to him. I repeat, is not granted to him. And in response to this, there is a term when we talk about, if suppose we are talking about justice, in response to this, Supreme Court in the early 1980s devised a mechanism. So children, what is the full form of PIL? PIL means public interest litigation. I repeat, public interest litigation. It was launched, or it was a mechanism to increase access to justice. It allowed any individual or organization to file a PIL in the High Court or Supreme Court on the behalf of those whose rights were being violated. The legal process, I repeat, was greatly simplified, and even a letter or telegram addressed to the Supreme Court or the High Court could be treated as a PIL. And in the early years, PIL was used to secure justice on a large number of issues, such as rescuing bonded laborers. First point, rescuing bonded laborers from inhuman work conditions. Then securing the release of prisoners in Bihar who had been kept in jail even after their punishment term was complete. So, did you even know that the midday meal that children now receive in government and government aided schools is just because of PIL, is because of PIL. So, in short, we can say that PIL is another method through which people are able to file cases or make appeal in the courts. For the common person, to access to court at times becomes a little messy, or you can say a little bit controversial. And justice actually, which is wanted or acquired by the person, is not received on time. So we can easily say that PIL or public interest litigation is a way or a method in which many people have been benefited and got justice without any problem. Now, moving further, there is a picture on your screen. Children, can you see this picture? And actually a poster. Can you see what is it? This picture describes, children, the death by hunger. And what do you understand by this picture? Can you think for a minute? If we are talking about death by hunger, then what does this death by hunger mean? It means the Constitution provides right to food under the fundamental rights. And if this right is hurt or affected by any reason, the government is solely liable for this. If one dies out of hunger, the government is responsible for it. Very recently, we have seen cases of suicide by the farmers. Many a times, so although it is not so recent, but many a times it happens that we have seen and heard the suicide cases of farmers. The government has to check such happenings. Sometimes traders cause such situations by hoardings. A crisis of food is created by these hoardings. The government must find out these hoarders and punishment. What happens actually that the people really feel disappointed and hopeless when they are not able to serve their family in the right manner. And as a result of depression, they commit suicide out of hunger. So this is also a sin. This is also a violation of a law. And the government is wholly and solely responsible for such people and is answerable for such kind of step taken by the people. Moving ahead with the definitions, children, you can see these definitions: acquit, compensation, eviction, and violation. These new terms you have to mark in your notebooks, write in your FAIR notebooks, and and these short terms are given in your NCERT pole science book, textbook. So before moving ahead or before ending the class, I would like to explain these terms. Acquit means, it refers to the court declaring a person, he or she who might have been considered as a guilty person, but who is declared that he or she was tried by the court for a particular allegation, but he is found non-guilty. Compensation, in the context of this chapter, it refers to the petition filed for a higher court to hear a case that has already been decided by a lower court. Eviction, it refers to the removal of persons from land or homes that are currently living in. Violation means to going against something or to break laws. So children, for now, that's it. And by this, the chapter is finished. Thank you, and Sairam.